हेलो माय डियर व्यूअर्स, वेलकम टू सिंप्लीफाइड सिविल एंड जियोटेक्निकल इंजीनियरिंग चैनल। आई एम अक्षय जायसवाल। इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन अबाउट सोर्सेस ऑफ वाटर, सरफेस सोर्सेस ऑफ वाटर, सब सरफेस सोर्सेस ऑफ वाटर, इन्फिल्ट्रेशन गैलरीज, पोरस पाइप गैलरीज, स्प्रिंग्स एंड डगवेल। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द वीडियो।
लेक्चर नंबर 2, पब्लिक हेल्थ इंजीनियरिंग, इट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज एनवायरमेंटल इंजीनियरिंग। चैप्टर नंबर 1, quantity and quality of water. It has weightage of 12 marks. Teaching hours allotted to this chapter are 8. Syllabus point covered: surface and subsurface sources of water. Objective: describe various surface and subsurface sources of water. Sources of water. Sources from where a town gets water are either underground or surface water sources, but these sources ultimately depend upon the main source, that is rainwater. Since rainwater, which flows from streams, rivers, percolates to form underground source, this percolated water forms natural pipeline underground. Water runs in the form of river, or it is stored in the reservoir, lakes, and in the catchment area, and comes out in the form of spring, well, and infiltration galleries. We will discuss spring, well, and infiltration galleries in detail in next few slides. Following are the factors which affects the selection of source of water. The source selected should provide water throughout the year to a city or town. The quantity of water available from the source selected should be adequate to meet the public demand. The water source selected should be cheap. The quality of water from the source selected should be so good as not to require any expensive treatment. Next point is surface and subsurface sources of water. Sources of water are given below. First one is surface sources, means which are above the ground level. First one is streams, second rivers, third one is lake, fourth ponds, and fifth is natural or artificial reservoirs. Next point is subsurface sources, means the sources which are below the ground level. First point is spring, galleries, porous pipe galleries, wells, and infiltration wells. These are the subsurface sources. Surface sources are known as ground sources. Water can be easily stored naturally or artificially on the earth's surface. Surface sources include streams, rivers, lakes, ponds, artificial reservoirs, streams, etc. Streams in mountainous region, during rainy season, water from top of the mountain get collected and flows in the form of streams. These streams, which dry up in the summer, are known as rainy streams. The quality of water in streams is normally good to some extent, but if it flows over mud, clay particles get mixed with the water. Fine particles cannot be removed by the filtration and are removed by some special treatment. Point number 2 is rivers. Number of small streams flowing over from mountains combined together to form a river. River is the only surface source of water which is available in abundance and can be easily used. Mostly all the cities situated near the river discharge their sewage in the river. Nowadays this has become a major problem to the environmental safety. In India, some rivers are perennial, which flows 12 months, while others dry up in the summer. Point number 3 is lakes. In mountains, at some places, natural basins are formed with impervious bed. Water from streams generally moves towards this region to form a lake. Generally, water in lakes is of good quality because the water is still and undisturbed. Natural sedimentation takes place, means heavier particle present in the lake gets settled down at the bottom, and this process is known as sedimentation process. Lake water is suitable for the industrial use. Fourth point is ponds. Ponds are depression in plains in which water is collected during rainy season. Ponds are mostly found in small villages. Point number 5, natural or artificial reservoirs. In India, reservoirs are a major source of water in summer. Reservoirs have large capacity to store water, which is utilized by people in deficient period. Meaning of deficient period is that, suppose in summer season, water is not available in sufficient quantity, then in this season, we can use the water which is already stored in reservoir. Our next title is subsurface sources. These are also known as underground sources. A portion of rainfall infiltrates the ground and gets stored as subsurface water at hard stratum. Meaning of infiltration is that when rainfall occurs, water moves in downward direction and it passes through the several layers of the ground, and it is stored as a subsurface water at the hard stratum, and this process is known as infiltration. Subsurface sources primarily can be divided into other sources such as wells, tube wells, spring, infiltration galleries, porous pipe galleries, etc. These mainly depend on the underground water table, which ultimately depends on the nature of the soil. If sand is present, then water will move quickly into the ground. If clay is present, then water will not move easily into the ground because clay has property of holding the water. Permeable soil percolates in large quantity, which results in increase of water table. Next point is springs. Sometimes where the groundwater is very high, the water comes out on the surface in the form of spring. Due to the presence of sulfur in certain soil, they discharge hot water. The following are the main two types of spring. First one is gravity spring and second one is artesian spring. So let's see gravity springs in detail. In this case, the underground water level rises and water outflows to the sides of natural valley or depression. The water table fluctuates regularly and the quantity of water in gravity springs becomes uncertain. The flow of water may be reduced to zero. Now we will discuss about artesian spring. These are the wells from which water flows automatically under the pressure. This water can be stored in water tanks. These are mostly found in hilly regions. Condition of formation of spring is, when the surface of the earth drops sharply below the normal groundwater table, then springs are formed. Here we can see ground level, and here water table is shown in this figure. When rainfall occurs, water infiltrates into the ground in the downward direction and water table rises. Here we can see water table, or we can say level of water table. Water moves in horizontal direction and then it comes out from this surface. When water comes out from the surface area, this process is known as formation of spring. These are few examples of gravity spring. When rainfall occurs, then water moves in downward direction and it moves in horizontal direction and it comes out from this surface, and this process is known as formation of spring, or we can say spring. This type of formation is also known as gravity spring. In this example, same process occurs. Here rainfall occurs, water moves in the downward direction, it flows in this horizontal direction and it moves out from this ground surface, and formation of spring takes place. Here water moves outside from this surface, here water moves outside from this surface, and this process is known as formation of spring. Here also water is moving outside from this surface, and this outward flow is known as spring. I think the spring is clear now. Here are few examples which shows formation of spring. Here we can see water moves out from this surface area and a person is collecting water in the bottle, and this is one example of spring. This picture shows formation of spring, means water percolates through these rocks and it comes out from this rock surface, and here a lake, or we can say a surface storage, is created. This outward flow of water from this rock surface is known as formation of spring. Here we can see third example which shows formation of spring. Here water is moving in outward direction from this surface.
In this figure we can see common type of spring, which is also known as surface spring. This figure shows groundwater table. Here we can see spring. This is impervious stratum. This surface spring is formed when, due to an obstruction, groundwater is collected in the form of reservoir and forces the water to overflow at the surface. Now let's discuss infiltration gallery. Generally, groundwater flows towards the ponds or lakes, that is, water flows in this horizontal direction towards lakes or ponds. This water can be intercepted by digging canal or tunnel with the holes at right angle. Example, this is tunnel having holes at this surface. These underground tunnels are called as infiltration gallery. This figure shows infiltration gallery. This is groundwater table. Here a gallery is made below this ground surface. Flow of groundwater takes place. In this surface, holes are made which allows the entry of water inside this surface area, and from this surface area water is collected in these pipes and it is collected inside this gallery. From this gallery the collected water can be taken out and we can use it later. Here theoretical part is shown in this figure. Now we will see its real example. This picture shows its real example. Here water is collected inside this gallery through these pipelines as shown in this figure. This is inside picture of this gallery. Amount of water collected in this gallery can be taken out by pumping and we can use it later. Our next point is porous pipe galleries, where there is large quantity of groundwater available over a large area. It can be cheaply collected by laying porous pipes. These pipes collect and dispose collected water
Here a well is constructed to take out water. Here we can see pipe along its longitudinal direction, means along its length. Holes are made on the top surface of this pipe, which allows entry of water inside this pipe. If we observe this pipe from this direction, means along its cross section, in this cross section we can see earth surface, pipe which is surrounded by gravel, sand and broken stone pieces, and this is porous pipe gallery, and water is collected inside this pipe because of holes which are present on this surface, and at the bottom concrete lining is provided. Our next point is wells, vertical hole drilled under the ground to trap the subsoil water is called as well. Wells may be shallow or deep. The well must be dug minimum 20 meters away from the source of communication. Wells are classified as dug well, driven well, tube well, and the diameter of these wells may be from 1 meter to 4 meter, and depth may vary from 2 meter to 9 meter, and they are less than 20 meter in depth. These wells are suitable for small discharge, and figure shows dug well. As stated here, diameter of this well is from 1 meter to 4 meter, and depth may vary from 2 meter to 9 meter, and they are less than 20 meter in depth. This figure shows few examples of dug well. Here impervious layer is present, and at bottom coarse grained aquifer is present. This is pervious concrete lining. Pervious concrete lining is done at the surface of this dug well. This concrete lining prevents the fall of this ground surface inside this well. This diagram shows dug well. At the bottom of this dug well, gravel filter is provided. Here casing is provided to avoid the fall down of earth surface inside this dug well. Here we can see water table which is present inside this dug well. A pipe is provided so that we can take water which is collected inside this dug well. At the uppermost layer, concrete slurry is provided to fix this dug well. And at the top surface of this dug well, solid concrete cover is provided. At a depth of 2.5 meter, clean sand and gravel layer is provided in the surrounding area of this dug well. Depth of dug well above the ground surface is 0.4 meter. And in this way, this both figure shows dug well. And our last point is infiltration wells. The shallow wells constructed under the beds of river are called as infiltration wells. These are provided to increase the yield of well during summer.
Hope you like the information given in this video. If you are watching my channel for first time, then click on subscribe and share with all your friends. Thanks for watching. Jai Hind, Vande Mataram.